Let's talk about the open source Llama Stack project and how it can help to build generative AI applications that use RAG or agentic capabilities. But in a bigger picture, I want to talk about what it means to build enterprise-ready AI applications, right? And how this wave is quite similar to the moment that we had in Kubernetes just a few years back. So let me explain. Because at first, building with AI models was quite simple, right? So let me give you this hypothetical. Right, if I was to make a call to a model, like an LLM that's running locally or maybe in the cloud, bam, we have inference capabilities. But then we needed to add all sorts of useful features to our AI applications. This could involve adding data retrieval, right, through a method like RAG, where we're going to a vector database, pulling that and adding that to the LLM. Or maybe we wanted to interact with APIs and we wanted to add agentic functionality, right? So this could be through MCP or other ways of calling out to APIs and getting that data back. But there's also the idea of measuring how useful our application was, right? So we could use evaluations in order to measure, hey, is our application doing what it should do? And you could also think of, hey, do we need guardrails so we don't leak our data? All of these different components that we had to organize that might use vendor-specific implementations. The thing is, this got quickly quite chaotic and difficult for teams to move. So the idea with Llama Stack is to actually bring this together and to standardize these different layers of a generative AI workload with a common API that can run from a developer's laptop to the edge to an enterprise data center and more. So we can think about this situation again, where we're making a request from Llama Stack, which is our central API to rule them all, that allows us to plug and play with different components. So that means those who need, you know, choice and customizability are able to fulfill all of their regulatory, privacy, and budgetary needs, and now have these pluggable interfaces for features like, for example, inference and agents and guardrails, right? All of these different components. And just as Kubernetes defines these core standards for managing containers and allowing different vendors and projects to provide components like container runtimes or CI/CD or storage backends, Llama Stack is repeating this pattern for generative AI applications. And not just for Llama models, but any model that can run in OLLaMA, VLLM, and many other inference providers. So let's see how this works in action. I'm going to give you an example use case. First off, let's tackle the most common enterprise AI situation, which is chatting with our documentation and data, probably in a format such as RAG, to add in custom data to our large language model. Now, what Llama Stack does differently is provides these commonly used APIs, such as, for example, inference, so the ability to run models, or vector.io as the ability to search a vector database. And there's many more. But the thing is, the API itself doesn't know how to perform the task, but instead a consistent way to ask for it. That's specifically where the API providers come in, which are these specific implementations that do the work. So for inference, the API could be providing to, say, for example, OLLaMA, or maybe a production-ready runtime like VLLM, or maybe something hosted by a third party like Grok. Yeah, at the same time, though, the vector provider could be working with something like maybe ChromaDB, right? Or maybe, say, Weaviate or something like that. You could kind of see the possibilities here that you can plug and swap out these different providers against the Llama Stack API without changing your actual source application code. So maybe you start working locally with OLLaMA to get things up and running on your machine. And then when you're ready to move into production, you would switch to VLLM with just a single configuration line. Now, you might want to work with a specific set of providers because of hardware support or contractual obligations. So this is what's known as the distributions, the distros, which are pre-packaged collections of providers that makes setup easier. So this could be, for example, locally hosted, right, where you're working with OLLaMA, or maybe some type of remote type of distribution where you're working with, you know, third-party APIs and you're just providing an API key. So you're able to test maybe on a mobile phone or take this to edge or production with a simple configuration edit. Now, let's come back to our example because our team now needs to add agentic capabilities in order to retrieve information from our database and update our CRM, maybe to add a Slack message, et cetera, et cetera. So with Llama Stack and these different APIs and providers, we're able to build an agent to use predefined tools that interact with the outside world. In this case, it's going to be Model Context Protocol, or MCP servers. So we could have one MCP server that's defined as a tool group for Postgres, and we could also have one here for Slack. And just as we've registered providers, for example, with inference and for our vector databases, we can also register tool groups, which will point to these MCP servers. And this keeps the core Llama Stack philosophy that your agent's code is decoupled from the specific tool's implementation. So here we could either create a workflow with maybe prompt chaining or a manual approach, and maybe even build a React agent that could act autonomously to bring in this information to our AI app. But at the end of the day, as AI engineers, developers, and platform engineers, we're all trying to build enterprise-ready AI systems. And the idea of Llama Stack is to have full control and run your own generative AI platform without having to build it from scratch. And instead of worrying about supporting multiple vector stores or working with different types of APIs, it allows us to focus on innovation and build scalable but portable AI applications. You can use either Docker or Podman to run Llama Stack locally with containers, and I encourage you to head to GitHub or other sources and try it out yourself. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please feel free to give us a like and stay subscribed for more videos on AI and technology.